Hello, my delicious co-creators. Lilou here in beautiful Nantes. Actually, a little chilly, hein, compared to Paris.
Yeah, absolutely. It's very cold, actually, here.
I'm with Nako. You probably recognize this awesome man if you haven't seen the video on YouTube. I love, what is that song called? It's those beautiful images. They're so
important. Aloha Kiakua.
Aloha Kiakua. Where does this inspiration come from? And if you haven't seen this video, please check it out. I'm amazed at the quality of course, of the music, but the images, everything. How inspired is that? Where does this come from?
Well, it's interesting that the video came as a gift to from a stranger. And it fits so perfectly into the meaning in the song. But the song came from a couple years before that, and living in Hawaii and really being asking myself what I would do if I could choose where I wanted to be in the world to watch things change dramatically in the world. I was like, where would it be? And I was like, would it be in Hawaii? I don't know. And so this song came out of me questioning, like, even my existence, you know, in the world, and then creating a prayer for myself, like a mantra, which is Aloha Keakua. Aloha is the breath of life. Keakua is of God. So you have a phrase that is very common in Hawaiian philosophy, that also in Akuleana is your responsibility in life. And so this like philosophy was something that I was focused on at the time of writing a song. And then the gift of the video came later, where somebody found the recording of me just one day playing the piano, and then attached it to this beautiful montage of footage from around the world, mostly in Mexico and
high quality
in South America. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It's high definition with just beautiful.
I mean, for a second, like, you're an artist and somebody takes your artwork, and for, in my case, it's a song, and they find it such an inspirational song, and then they take their own work of art, which is, they actually just bought this footage online. It's stock footage for commercials in South America. And then they pieced it together, and nobody else has seen this thing, but they pieced it together and it fit the song so well that the song went viral.
Totally viral, millions of views. It seems like you're very much into this collaborative sharing, coming all together, creating this, even how your, can we say, even group or band come together. It's not even a band. Tell us about that, because it seems very much in the air du temps, as we say in France, because we're here in Nantes in France.
Sure, yeah. Yeah, the story of us coming together as a group is very natural. There was never a moment in time where I, in my writing and being a poet and a musician, thought, oh, let's make a band and go on tour, you know? It was always about, hey, you want to play the drums, or hey, you should play bass, or something like this, you know? And so it transformed over years of just me being open to whatever the universe wanted me to do. If it felt right, you know, it would happen. And so this is where the tribe came from, you know? And the essence of also from where I come from, I've over the years been on like a, as we all are, on a journey to self-discovery, to identifying myself to a land or to a community or to a culture. And so through that search, this is how the band came. You know, I was out.
Where are you from? You were adopted? Yeah, I mean, there's a mix of.
Yeah, there's a bit of a story. I mean, I was adopted when I was 9 months old, and then I was, my mother that adopted me raised me in Oregon, in Portland, in the Northwest. But my birth mother is Native American and Puerto Rican, and then my father is Filipino and Chamorro, which is the people of Guam.
What a great mix. Did you ever, how was it for you growing up, and did you ever had to do some forgiveness or go through some deep issues? Because I know a lot of us right now are going through this stuff, and we must do it, otherwise it just comes through the back door and it's pretty bad.
Sure.
We must do the work, don't we?
Yeah, there's definitely no escaping it. I mean, there is, in Native American like spirituality, there's two ways that you can live. You know, there's the way of the red road, which is the way of constant walking alongside creation and working with it. Always giving what you can and taking only what you need. And then there's the way of the black road, which is to live a life of just self-indulgence, to always just be serving yourself, right? So you always have this path, you know. It's one or the other, you know. And when I was growing up, I actually had a really nice childhood. I was raised super in the suburbs, like I was homeschooled, and I went to church like 4 times a week, was raised very Christian. And when I was becoming a young adult, I left home like at 17 years old and went off on a journey to figure out what I wanted to do with my life. And that journey just took me to places like Alaska. I was a skilled piano player, and so this was my job. Like I was learning how to, I was music directing. And I was teaching piano lessons and stuff like that. But I got a job in Alaska to be a music director for a dinner theater. And I opened up to creation up there, to nature. I had never been in like Alaska. It was crazy. It's just like boom, like majesty, like amazing nature, you know. And was opened up to Native American philosophy up there, and learned about the culture of the people, the land there. And then I moved to Hawaii and never left. I was there. I've been there for almost a decade now.
Which one? Because when we speak of Hawaii, there's those 7 islands. So which one?
The Big Island. Yeah.
Oh, the volcano, the chakra, the root chakra, is it?
Yeah, they call it the Pico, which is like the center. The Pico of the Pacific is the belly button of the planet.
Yeah. Yeah. You had some specific inspiration there. What's your contact? Did you met some kahunas or had some special encounters?
You know, what really was interesting is that I never had a teacher. A specific like elder,
and this showed up.
Yeah, well, in this time of my life, it's like I've collected my aunties and uncles. Now I'm like, okay, now I got my aunts and uncles, you know. But at that time, when I first moved to Hawaii, it was the land that was like, come here. And like within the first year that I was there, I was given an opportunity to lease a piece of land, and so my brother, you know, and I, we got to this property, and it was completely, you know, it was just land, beautiful land. And we were like, okay, well, we don't have any money. We don't know what to do. We've just been here for a year learning about permaculture. And we were like, okay, well, I guess let's try and see what we can do. It was a tough 3 years of like working construction and like, you know, landscaping and just getting by to eventually create this piece of property that we have now, which is a beautiful place, a beautiful home.
Is this home for you now?
Yeah, I mean, I'm traveling so much now, I'm not there very much anymore. But eventually I will go back and, you know, have deeper roots. But yeah, it wasn't then at that time of my life that I was learning through elders. I would say that those kind of things opened up and started happening with me over the last 4 years. To learn about why I feel connected to the land and why I feel connected to people, or why I feel connected to spirit, you know, and why I feel connected to bringing people together to help them understand that connection through the music.
Medicine for people, huh? So you're, the music is kind of, can we say, a shamanic, medicinal, healing energy? Where does that come from? Tell us, and what do you think it does to people, or how do you feel your own music, I guess, because it's hard to speak for others.
yeah, exactly, because we're all so similar, but we're all so different, right? So to understand what happens to people, I don't know specifically for each of them as an individual what happens to them, because everyone's journey is different. But I can understand on a broad human level, energetically, what can happen and what has happened and what I've witnessed. It's really remarkable. I mean, honestly, it's miraculous, you know, just the testament of the power of music. I could get up on stage and say a bunch of crap and you know, have a negative attitude or whatever, and people who want to have that kind of like vibe will come to my show. Which is why we have
likes attract like. You believe in the law of attraction?
Excuse me?
Likes attract like. Do you believe in the law of attraction?
For sure, absolutely. Yeah, absolutely. That's why we're here.
Yeah, baby.
I mean, okay.
He's a bit of a comedian, too.
But I've thought about this a lot, yeah. You know, because you know, coming for like the last 3 or 4 years now, the exponential growth of the message and of my life, my own life, just like, oh, I'm writing about these things, my life and stories, and I see how over the last 3 years, 4 years, how much people have like opened up because of that.
Like when you say that, like open their heart, open their potential, heal.
All of these things, you know, whether it's I get word from somebody that's in the war in the Middle East, an American soldier, or if it's somebody that's on the reservation in whatever part of the country in the U.S. that they're from, or if it's a community from Australia, or it's from Israel, or it's from Canada or South America. Now it's like, because it's gone so far, and where it started was my own like spirit like asking to understand this existence, you know, and how I want to walk in the world, you know. So it's, whether it's a beatitude like forgiveness or staying humble or understanding your darkness so that you can see the light better.
It's a lot of shadow work, and you have to go beyond it. You felt like you were carrying that, but you had anger to go over through to go through.
Oh yeah, always. You know, and I don't think that you ever. I think that there's so many chapters that you go through. You know, like these songs, and the lessons within them are constantly coming back around. You know, I'll relearn the same.
Keep on learning, as you say.
Yeah, and it's not the same lesson in particular, but it could be another version of it from a different
layer.
Yeah, different layer. It's crazy, you know. It's absolutely. It's just.
Makes sense.
Yeah. So it is an interesting time of awakening. I think that I'm really inspired to be a part of a generation right now that that is taking things more seriously. I think as far as spiritually aware, perhaps with their bodies as well as warfare within the spirit world. There's so much that goes on that we don't necessarily see if you're not looking out for it. You know, in which case, like creating ceremony with music, I think is super.
Ayahuasca?
Well, no, I mean, like with, because I know what you mean, but like there's, and that's the thing is like there's so much like appropriation of spirituality and so much appropriation of ceremony because we don't have enough teachers, you know, and the knowledge has been passed down, but it's gotten like, just like religion, it's gotten down here at the bottom, it's gotten really like, misconstrued.
And you take shortcuts, and it became shallow when it used to be huge ceremonies.
Yeah,
taking your time and going through long rituals.
Yeah, all of our ancestors, wherever you come from, wherever I come from, they all used to do this kind of ceremony where it was they took it seriously the way that we would pray and the way that we would ask for things. You know, from the spirit world. And now, you know, I think that what I like to sort of like think of what I'm doing or as I'm trying to do is in my own way in the merging of the old and the new is to bring my version of ceremony and my version of prayer to the touring world, to the industry side of things, you know, and be like, okay, this is how I'm going to hold space and pray with y'all. This is my story I'm going to share with you, but I also know that like these songs are doing something for you. Whether you understand the language or you understand the intention, it's like there's vibe and there's so much to say for vibe, you know? Yeah.
Yeah. Do you create? No, it's so cool. I love his music. My God, if you don't know it, you have to check it out. It feels so good. The soul loves it. The soul wants more of this kind of stuff. It makes sense. Do you actually set an intention, a prayer? How do you start? Or you just start to sing when you do a concert? Like tonight, this is pretty big venue here in Nantes. We're happy to have you all the way west of France. This is cool. Are you going to prepare or just go?
I always prepare. I mean, we as a group circle up before we play every night and we...
Do a circle?
Yeah.
Hold hands?
Yeah. And we always just give thanks for our travel, to our safe travel to wherever we're coming to.
Gratitude, gratitude, gratitude.
It's about gratitude because look what we get to do. You know, we get to, you know, this is great. No matter, you know, day in and day out, sometimes in a different country, you're like, oh man, what? And then you're like, oh, I want to go home. And you're like, ah, man, this is like a dream, you know.
Awaken dream.
Yeah, awaken dream to reality. So it's. So it's pretty cool. It is a blessing, you know, and it's a gift to even get to do this kind of a thing. But we do circle up. We have our little prayer, you know. We do our little gratitude circle, and then we just remind each other to pay attention to each other and to pay attention to the vibe and to know when to push hard and when to step back a bit. And it's all energetic work, you know. It really is. It's pretty wild.
is there some things that happened to you, kind of mystical experience on stage, or you started feeling something, or somebody said, oh my God, I've seen this other thing, you surrounded by this energy?
Yeah, well, because you know, most bands are gonna play and focus on what it's like to play with each other. And we do that, but for us, most of the time, it's like we have a good show when we know that we've communicated with the crowd and that there's been an exchange going on. So all the magic will happen when there's an exchange happening. Whether it's, we've had people faint at our shows before, crazy. And we've cried during our shows because of the exchange of feeling people so strongly going through their work, of recognition, of remembering, of accepting and of releasing and then taking on and letting go. You know, it's like, it's full on ceremony, you know? And like, and it's a crazy thing for some people who aren't used to going to a show to have that experience, have it happen to them or to witness it. They go, oh, I don't want to be, you know, and then they get attracted by it because they can feel it. You know, it's magnetism.
Yeah. Hope you're going to be in Hawaii in August. I'll be there interviewing, doing some more interviews. This is Maui, Kauai. Kauai is my favorite one. I just love it.
I have some people that I'll tell you later if you want that you should meet. Some powerful
Elijah.
Teachers of mine. Oh. Yeah. Oh, you're going to meet Elijah.
I love Elijah. He's been on my channel for many years.
Oh, rad. Yeah.
He's my brother.
Yeah, he's my brother too. The Band of Light.
Yes.
But some true Kanaka Maolis, you know, like some teachers of mine that are over there as well.
Super. Last little word of wisdom or something that you would like to share with us today, or like, because this is so international, you know, like you, I feel very much connected. I don't know if I'm American, French anymore, whatever. I feel yeah, like it's global.
You're a globetrotter. You're a student of the international planet. Yeah.
So this goes everywhere. Is there something, and it's cool with the internet, in a nanosecond we can just get it out.
Yeah.
Well, depending on your internet connection, that's another story here in France. It's a bit slow, you probably noticed.
It's really slow, hey? I was like, there's so many satellites in cameras right now. We gotta have better connections. Final word, I think that last year was the year of the horse. And sometimes I forget to look at things in their polarities and the and how much we need and don't often realize why we seek balance. But so the beginning of the year, the horse year, I was like, oh, you have to ride hard. It's horse year. We got to ride hard. Fuck, go hard, you know, and just like blazing, you know, and blazing the path and going, you know, and then towards the end of the year, I was like, oh, I should probably pull the reins back a bit, you know, and this year's the year of the goat, you know, and the goats are the symbol.
What do you do with a goat?
Well, you climb. So the goats are mountain climbers. Yeah. So the goats climb and they climb high, in which case there's no turning back. So for me, this year in 2015 is about going to that next level, recognizing what that even means to you, and then
if you really want to go there.
Well, and then commitment, commit to it and go, you know, and don't turn back because you can't. Yeah.
Super inspiring. It's been a delicious pleasure to interview you. Thank you so much. I wish you a mahalo. Oui, merci. I wish you an amazing concert tonight, and we'll be here to watch.
First time.
Yes. Magnifique. Delicious co-creators. If you don't know Nakoya, check it out. Big, big kisses to all of you guys from all around the world. Much love. I'm on the journey.
Well, I will learn to be peaceful, but I keep my knife at my side. I will pray for compassion. Whoa, but if war comes to my door, you know I will be blasting warrior mentality. My responsibility, bringing it to my people now. Holler if you're feeling me. Can I make my situation? My situation, I come from a long line of people in displacement. I am an Indian, I'm on a mission. Each time I'm stepping at the call for certain kinds of patience. I'm changing, it's amazing. Every day is a new day for this Indian in training. I am a hustler, got all kinds of customers. People need their medicine, there's music from all sponsorships. Past, present, future. could you dance? All the healing elements. Everything you do in life is definitely relevant. Where are your people? Where you, where your people? Where are your people? Where you, where your people? Where are your people? Where you, where your people? Making a masterpiece with the strength of an ego. Where are your people? Where you, where your people? Where are your people? Where you, where your people? Where are your people? Where you, where your people? Making a masterpiece, yes, and business, this is lethal. I will learn to be peaceful, but I keep my knife at my side. I will pray for compassion. Whoa-oh. But if war comes to my door, you know I will be blasting. Warrior mentality, my responsibility, bringing it through my people now.